This is going to be a really, 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 really quick video. Back in the Nerd Cave again. And I just picked up two boxes from the thrift store. Well, one box and one HP... Why did they put this stuff on the bottom? HP Pavilion... Whatever that says. A1630N. This... is an AMD dual core 4600, supposedly 2 gigs of RAM. I don't know, hard drive is 250 gig. Everything is inside of it. It's got a light scribe DVD drive, you know, all the good stuff. It's got that stuff. I'll do a better video tonight of it. And then there's this. Guessing this is to some printer that I don't need, but I can probably modify this to work on something else that I need. This has a lot of cards in it, one of which is a nice ISA Creative Focus. There we go. It doesn't say which one it is right off the top of my head. Alright, yeah, I'll have to figure that out at another time. Got a network card in there, which ain't really a big deal. There is a bunch of computer mice, mouses, and most of them are these. Those are indestructible, and then there's the occasional like that with a scroll wheel. It's pretty cool. Now, this looks like it could possibly be a life-saving device. Even though, you know, it's not very... You know, it's a 2.4 gigahertz, so... You know, it is wireless G, okay. But since you're going over USB, how much speed are you really going to get? And there's a bunch of other power adapters, printer cables. I know there's the occasional model or monitor cable. Ugh, monitor cable. There we go. And even a couple Zip 100 drives. Yeah, I'm not as happy about those. But, you know... Oh, there's actually 4 zip drives in here. I wonder if there's any zip discs. Ooh, that's broken. And this goes to some sort of Samsung camera. Alright, so, you know... Got all 5 zip drives. Sorry if that was very loud in your ear. And this one's a Zip 250. Yeah, so I have 4 Zip 100s and at least 1 Zip 250. Well, those were not amazing things, but, you know, they are what they are. But, yeah, so I'm going to keep this short and... You know. Oh, and if Billy Core is listening, I have been asked to clean out their basement of the computers at this thrift store. And I really wish I had taken a picture of it. But I will be picking up a Packard Bell tower. It looks a lot like his 820 CDT. I'm really sorry if I got that number wrong, Billy. And I will be picking up a Packard Bell monitor with the speakers. I believe it's the digital one. And a Packard Bell keyboard and mouse. So I will have an entire Packard Bell system. You know, computer, monitor, keyboard and mouse. And, I forget what model it was. I really should have taken a picture, but, you know, we were trying to get out of the, you know, basement as quickly as possible, you know, because there were customers in the store. And, so, with that being said, I'm going to close this and say thank you for watching, have a blessed day, and, I will see you later tonight, probably with this HP. Alright, so I'm back down here again with this, HP Pavilion A1630N, and Actually, I have to be honest with you guys. I've already had it on because I had to repair my router. And I'm down in the basement. And that involves going outside, then upstairs. And, yeah. I didn't know I had a problem until I was down here. So, I actually thought to myself, hey, for the first time, I'm going to have a HP computer on an HP monitor. And then I realized, this is a Westinghouse. Yeah. Hey, shows what I know, right? So, yeah, this machine's got a lot of your typical things. It's got the Athlon 64x2 dual-core processor. It's got the light scribe. Hey, can your PC do this? And, you know, that stuff. And then it's also got this here, which from what I understand is a type of USB hard drive that you can take out, and it's some proprietary thing that they had. You know, it's got all your typical fare on the back. I may have forgotten to post a video to YouTube, so I'll do that when I get upstairs. But, yeah, so I showed that this morning. And, so, yeah, I don't know why it keeps doing it. I think it keeps losing the connection to my router, which is like 60 feet that way, and then to the second story floor apartment. But anyway, that's really not all that, you know, going on the internet is not important to this video, really, but, alright, so, okay, I hear somebody walking down the steps. I'm going to turn it on. And it actually, I've never messed with XP Media Center Edition before. This is a first for me. And it comes up with that, I don't know. Too much about it. And then it'll come up and once we take a quick look at the what's on it, I'll pop the cover on it. But while that's coming up, oh, comes with all the digital photography stuff. But this actually boots up pretty quick considering what it is. That was not actually me, but nor was the router set up one. But you know, it does have Realtek audio. Oh, that's weird. But you know, it's kind of weird theme going on. And what just happened? Yeah, I think I might upset some people and say I really don't miss XP that much. There's what we have there. For some reason it showed it was a 999 megahertz earlier. But, I don't know. Yeah, nothing's missing. So, what do we have in here? Snapfish, hot deals. Oh, good lord! How is this thing even running? Got Norton. Got extra games. HP games. I'm nosy. I kind of want to see this. Okay, that was apparently on an external drive, but let's see. What's in my documents? Downloads. They were smart enough to wipe that. Ooh, I don't have any speakers hooked up. Real Player downloads. Somebody was into Facebook games. These look like... I don't know what they look like. But really, there isn't a whole lot to tell in here. It's got... Somebody did the extended service plan. Which is kind of interesting. I hear a siren. You can tell you're in South Jersey. So let's turn this off and take a look what's under the hood. I just shut that router off. I don't need it now. I didn't need it then. And once this is done shutting down, I'm going to unpause it. And all I've done is unplug the power, always important, and bleed off any power. Turn around and unscrew that. Now, let's see, what do we got in here? Very stock looking, what's the word I'm looking for? AMD cooler. And, everything inside of here is SATA, even the light scry burner. It's got the NVIDIA chipset. If I'm not mistaken, that, I believe, is the one that gets warm. And every SATA port is a different color. Interesting. That's a very obvious ASUS board, as demonstrated by that. It's got a PCIe slot, three PCI. There's the inside of that hard drive caddy thing. Yeah, for the most part, there isn't a whole heck of a lot to tell. It does have two parallel ATA ports and a fair amount of dust. You can tell I didn't do anything to this before taking a video. But, of course, they got the power supply on the other, the sticker on either the top. What? There is a fan grill up there, so it's pulling air through that little... Wow. I wonder if... Looks like it was done that way from the factory. Maybe? I don't know. That's crazy. So that explains why the sticker's on the other side. I couldn't help but to notice there was no grill there. So maybe the reason this showed up in the thrift store is because it gets hot. I don't know. But, yeah, that's a quick tour of this thing. You know, if I had... Of course, I don't have a Phillips on me. How do I keep coming down here without a Phillips screwdriver? Seriously, somebody tell me. I'm thinking it's because I'm an idiot. But, yeah, I was thinking when I took it apart in the thrift store that this looked a little non-factory based on, like, the sleeve. Actually, I thought, wow, that's pretty nice for HP that they have the, nice sleeves on the power supply cables. But maybe not. Maybe not. So, alright. You know, this is what it is. And what it is not that great, but not that bad. And, you know, considering that I paid $10 for this and that box of junk that I went through this morning, I'm actually just going to piece these two videos together, you know, so that it's all in one encompassing thing. But that box I paid, this box right here, I paid $10 for the PC. There's a keyboard that's in the toolbox of my truck that I'm too lazy to go get, which is an E-Machines keyboard, so it doesn't go with this. and that box. And on that note, I will go ahead and close this and say thank you for watching. Have a wonderful and a blessed day.